What is your middle name? West Australia. And when a lady sees a man that is rich and handsome, she forgets her first name. It's not you, you are a spirit. You are possessed. And we take all these things for granted. We see our life moving. You can't, even the money issue. Even the money issue. You see money, you forget your. Before you know, before you now remember about offering and tithe, you have already finished your money. It's not, it's a spirit. It's a spirit. When you want to achieve something, look for a strong man. Look for a powerhouse. Destroy it. But for me, I'm a household. Mark my word, on the last day you will see how many souls we are trafficking from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of his dear son. I'm not here wasting my, I don't have time to waste. As your pastor, I look. I'm here in the morning from 4 o'clock. I mean from 11 o'clock to 1. After 1, I see everything goes well, then I move. 2 o'clock, I go to Victoria Square. I'm not asking anybody. Because nobody see what I'm seeing. Huh? Nobody was seeing what Daniel was saying when he opened his door to pray, even when there was a sanction. Nobody. It was only Daniel. It was only Daniel. So nobody see what I'm seeing. Imagine my children that are potential of sailors business ending up in wrong while I have power to change it. Oh my gosh. If I start the battle now, they will follow me. So I don't need to pray for them again not to enter into drugs because they are now fighters. Imagine the whole spirit. Imagine what will the future of Australia be? Where my children are going to grow. And I have the power and authority to change the situation. And I'm here with my rolling or wasting my time. Or bet my God, I can't do it. I have a better business to do. I have lives to change. Many are still praying to go to heaven. Man, the Bible says we are already seated in heavenly places. We cry. How will you be praying to go where you are? It's lack of knowledge. What we should be praying for is our, he said to those he gave 5 talents, they multiplied, doubled it, he gave them 10 cities. That's what I'm thinking of. And God forbid that any of you under the sound of my voice will go to heaven and you receive 100 cities while I receive only 10 as your pastor. It cannot happen. For the husbandman will be the first to partake of the cross. For the husbandman, the farmer, the bread farmer, the head farmer should be the first. It's not a sin, but I'm going to challenge you. You have to forgive more than me. You have to pray more than me. You have to evangelize more than me. You have to all visit. Preach more than me before you be greater than me. And love your wife more than me. Love your children more than me. Love everybody more than me before you be greater than me. It's not something you can't bribe God. It's a just God. God cannot be mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that is what he will do. So God forbid that I'll be seeing heaven. No, I'm sitting in heaven. And tomorrow you'll be greater than me in heaven. No. Instead, I will initiate something you are not. Does that make sense? I'm the pastor. I'm seeing what you're not seeing. I'm challenging you this morning. Don't take life for granted. Do you know that even when God has planned that this belongs to you, do you know you cannot receive it unless you demand it from heaven and earth? You cannot get anything that rightly belongs to you until you demand it. So just the one I said, simple. Do you have a plot of land? Yes. Where you can farm? Yes. Is your plot of land right? Is that not yours? Good. Leave it for 3 months. Leave that plot. Is your plot of land? It's yours. If you go back to visit that land, will that land grow some trees after 3 months? Answer me, church.
Yes.
So the land will grow within 3 months, it grows something. At least if you left it bare and you came back after 3 months, will it grow some trees?
Yes.
I want to ask you a question. In those trees of fencing will grow. Will you find one food there, one food to eat, the good food to eat? Legumes or maize or cash crops or all these things. Example, rice. Will you find rice there? Will you find cocoyam there? But trees grow. Who grew them? They use it to do the ministry of the devil, fly to and fro, no purpose. Imagine me leaving Australia, going to America without winning soul, without sure of winning one soul. I can't spend my money. Or traveling to what is America? When I go to heaven, I have better place than that. Or going to India, or going to London, or going to Canada, without a proper plan of winning a soul. Go! I don't want the woman, ministry of the devil. Devil, where have you been? Go and fro. Canada, America, London, Australia. What have you achieved? I've only traveled Nigeria, Malaysia. Go and check Malaysia and find out whether Pastor Joseph passed through Malaysia. Yeah! The same way in Australia, I'm building something that will outlive me. That even when I'm not in the church I planted in Malaysia, it's still going on. You want to know Pastor Joseph, you don't need to. Just go to Malaysia, CGMI Malaysia. Hey, I love, how did this place start? Oh, Pastor is in Australia now. Doing and not after. God, don't send me where you don't have the purpose for me. God, don't give me the money that I will not use to serve. God, don't give me that friendship that will lure me into hell. I reject it and I refuse it for me and my family. For I will serve the Lord. I want to move you. I don't want you to go home today and just feel that everything just happened by chance. No. If you live your life by chance, you end up not achieving anything. There's a strong man. There's a strong man. I'll be fighting that strong man. 2009. Last year, after our women fellowship, after our women Mother's Day, the whole church was jam-packed. Everywhere was full. I looked. I saw strong men of Australia. Strong men from Sierra Leone. Strong men from Liberia. Strong men from Nigeria. Strong men from everywhere in the church. I looked. People there were rejoicing. Everybody was shouting. A successful Mother's Day, but I was seeing strong men. People that can never work together. If you are from Australia, you can't work with Liberia. Liberia cannot work with this. I saw people. If you are my group, I can't work with your group. If you are, I saw strong men. When they called me to minister, to pray for them, I said, I can't pray for strong men. I can't. It's not my anointing. You might not see what I'm seeing, but on the last day you will see it. I can't. I pray for those that really want the prayers. You see, you can't even listen to me. We are doing something, few of you that we are supposed to obey. The Bible says the Jews came to Jesus in John chapter 6, 29 and 28 and 29. He said, tell us what we must do. If we do it, and we will be doing the work of him that has sent us. And Jesus said, obey the one I have sent. And I'm your pastor, I'm giving you instruction, nobody is respecting me. I have prayer, people are rejoicing all over the world, people watching them are calling me on the phone. Pastor Joseph, congratulations, you are doing very well. We see everywhere green, green. I said, a lie, there's no green, he's strong man. And from that day, do you know what I did? I turned whatever I've leveled upside down. I turned it. I said, it's me and that strong man. It's either you accept, if we have a woman leader that is a senior lord, you work with the person. If you're a Liberia, we tore your heart. If you have a woman leader that is from Liberia, if you're a senior lord, you must work with all your heart. Otherwise, no church. I'm not going to do any other things. You think I make money? I make money when I do programs. That money go to hell for me to lose. So what shall it profit the man to get the reward? No dream of Mother's Day. I've told my wife and the women leader, if I don't see a healthy women meeting, no Mother's Day. No Mother's Day. I want to start with two or three that are faithful. If I see two or three women that are coming together with one heart, we are coming here to serve God. Immediately they come at the door, they remove all the strong men, remove all the cultural, remove all the class, remove all the group. If I only see two, then we are safe for Mother's Day. Otherwise, the church will just continue like this. I'm not interested. And if you are with me and you want, you have another place your eyes is, I will help you to go there. It's a very foolish thing for a pastor to want to bring somebody that God has not sent. He said, no one will come to you except the one that God has sent to you. There are strong men here today. I'm contending with my strong men. In my family, I have contended with a strong man. In my relationship with my children, I've done that. I don't need to prove to anybody I'm a genuine pastor. I've already done that in my nation. I'm here to raise pastors. I'm here to raise ministers. I'm not here to. And thank God I'm doing it. And thank God I've got one or two that are faithful. My assignment, next assignment, is to contend with the strong man of Australia. You see my level? You are enjoying Australia, but somebody else is fighting the strong man. And on the last day, you see, maybe we will I did great in Australia. I did. God will say, hello, Pastor Joseph, can you come out? That's in heaven. Say, can you put on the television how Australia became, you know, a nation for Christ? Then they'll put it. Maybe where we. There are other people that are doing that. I'm not the first. I'm not saying I'm the best. But I'm just contributing my work. He said, look at, he was among them. He focused on the spiritual thing. He wasn't on the physical. That's why he's there. That's why he's, man, I'm jealous. If there's anything I'm willing to lose my life for, it is my possession in heaven. It is my crown. If there's anything I'm willing to lose, my family, my wife, my children, God knows, and I'm not lying, it's my crown. I can't. But you know, I have been on this business for over 30 years, and it would be foolishness for me to just throw all I have achieved over 30 years. A lot of people, when I tell them my age, they don't believe me. Say Australia say you are doing well. When I tell them my age, I say yes. I know how long I've been a reverend minister. I know how long I've been a pastor. So for me to lose all these things, no, my crown. Church, are you ready to contend with a strong man of the month of March? There's a strong man that is saying you will not see the end of March. But I'm here to declare upon you that you will see the end of March. There's a strong man in that project. We need to pull down the strong man. Today is prayer, not teaching. Let's stand up and use this 15 minutes. and harassed you and deal with some things that need to be dealt with. Do you know the Bible says in Isaiah, if anybody is there, can you help me? Isaiah chapter 28, verse 18. He came to steal and to do what? To kill and to do what? And to destroy. But yet it doesn't make sense to us. It doesn't make sense. But Jesus said, I have come to stop his activities. Now you may have one and have it more abundant. Are you there? If you're there, help me read, please. Isaiah 28, verse 18.
Your covenant with death will be annulled.
Your covenant with death this month shall be destroyed. Your covenant, it doesn't matter where they are, you know, planning it. It doesn't matter the setup. It doesn't matter the setting. But one thing is certain, you will not die. You shall live and do the work of God. That is all, my sister. That's the word I want to get. We are going to open our mouth and say, Lord, I shall live and not die in the month of March. I refuse to be sick. No bad news will ever come near me. My people shall be strong. Remember, I'm going to anoint you. Remember, we are going to take Holy Communion. I want you to pray this prayer, be saturated with the power of God before you receive all these things, so that it will make sense. The Bible said the same message that has been preached to us was preached to them. But it never profited them because they did not miss it with faith, those that received it, according to Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2. Let's open our mouth and say, Lord, I reject and I refuse death. Bad news, Rakabo Shakaboya. I shall live with divine help in the month of March. Maruma Shakaboya. As I receive this anointing, as I receive this Holy Communion, he shall replenish the blood, weak cells in my body, weak things in my body. Masum telegede buriya. Marababababa. As I take this, as I abide this Holy Communion, Rebasu keborogo shikaboya. Maboko sun telege buriya baba. Ribabo sheke borogo toya. Borogobo shika boro baba. Ribabo sheke buriya. Marababa shika borogo toya. Lebaka shika toya. Mahagadesh. Lebrakateya. Musikado zanda na bahuriya baha. I can never be sick this month. My family, none of my family members will be sick. Makira gadelia, maregedeli basumbaragade, ibasuke poseteya, mosku preketeya basun teleboria, maraka boseketeya koria korokoto sinkerika tarabaria. You shall have whatever you say. Do you know in the scriptures people came? And we're saying, God, but this way he didn't do it. He didn't do it. God said, declare that thou may be justified. Tell me when you prayed for it. Tell me when you declared it. Tell me when I heard your cry. The Bible says in Psalms chapter 5, verse 3, early in the morning shall I make my prayers unto you. Early in the morning and look up. Tell me when you prayed about it. When you took time to fast about it, you say, declare now that thou will justify. Tell me that I will justify you. Now is opportunity for us to stop our stoppers, for us to stop every strong man. And we are taking it for granted. Church, we are going to open our mouth and say, this morning.